In the last video, I derived linear interpolation, piecewise linear function interpolation. Now I want to talk about piecewise cubic polynomial interpolation. That goes by the name cubic spline interpolation. So let me set up the problem in the same way as before. So we know the values at certain points, so x naught, y naught, x1, y1, say to xn, yn. So at n plus 1 points, n plus 1 values of x, we know the values of y. And we want to interpolate. So we want to find the values of y at some x not on this list. I can draw a graph of the interpolation. So this is x. This is y. So let's draw some points here. Say here's one point, here's another point, here's another point, and here's another point. These are values of x's. So this is x naught, x1, x2, and x3, and corresponding values of y, y naught, y1, y2, and this one here would be y3. The idea then is to draw an interpolating function here. Previously, we just drew straight lines between these points. That's piecewise linear interpolation. Now we're going to use cubic polynomials, and we can make the curve then much smoother with cubic polynomials. So it could look something like this, okay? So continuous function, but it could be continuous also in the first derivative. And we'll see that it can be also continuous in the second derivative. That makes it a very smooth interpolating function. But these are still piecewise. So this is g naught here between x naught and x1. This is g1 between x1 and x2. This is g2 then between x2 and x3. And the whole thing together is what we call g of x, okay? So what are then the, what are these g functions? So they're supposed to be cubic polynomials. So gi of x we'll write as ai times x minus xi plus bi cubed. This is a cubic polynomial, so x minus xi cubed plus bi x minus xi squared plus ci x minus xi plus the constant term di, okay? With n plus 1 points, then there are n of these piecewise cubic polynomials. So there are 4 coefficients for each piecewise cubic polynomial. So there are 4n coefficients in this problem, currently unknown, right? 4n values of the a, b, c's, and d's. So we need constraints. So let me just mark that here. So there are currently 4n unknowns, right, that we want to determine. So the analytical problem of determining the cubic spline interpolant is the problem of determining these 4n unknowns in these piecewise cubic polynomials. So to determine them, we need constraints. So what are our constraints? Well, the polynomial has to go through the points, right? So the gi polynomial has to go through the xi, yi point. So we have a gi of xi has to be equal to yi. And the gi polynomial has to go through the point on the right. So this is the point on the left, And it also has to go through the point on the right. So gi of xi plus 1 has to equal to yi plus 1. Okay? This is true for the n piecewise polynomials. So this works out then to 2n constraints, right? Okay, we're trying to find 4n unknowns. So now we have 2n constraints. So that means we're allowed 2n more constraints. Okay, to do that, we want this interpolating polynomial to be smooth. So at these points where the two polynomials connect, we know that the function is already continuous because of these first two constraints. But what we want now is that the derivatives then are also continuous. So we would like the derivative of g naught at x1 equal to the derivative of g1 at x1. And we would like the derivative of g1 at x2 equal to the derivative of g2 of x2. So those two constraints will be gi, the derivative of, say, g1 at x1. So gi prime, we're starting, let's start with like the derivative of g naught at x1. So gi prime at xi plus 1, we want equal to g1 prime at x1. So we want that equal to gi plus 1 prime at the same point, xi plus 1, okay? That will be n minus 1 constraints here, right? This is n minus 1 constraints. Because it's just at the midpoints, right? So we have n plus 1 points. We have the first point and the last point. So we only have n plus 1 minus 2, so n minus 1 constraints. Okay, 4n unknowns. This is 2n. This is n minus 1. So we can do another derivative to make this thing smooth. So we can have the second derivative of gi at xi plus 1 equal to the second derivative of gi plus 1 at xi plus 1. And this will give us another n minus 1 constraints. Constraints. Okay, so we can count. We have 4n unknowns, right? 4n unknowns. And then we have 2n plus 2 times n minus 1, so 4n minus 2 constraints. Okay? We're missing two constraints, so we need two more constraints. So two more constraints, so two constraints extra. There are different ways of doing that. I'll talk about what's called the not a not condition. We'll talk about that in the next video. So we're missing two constraints. But nevertheless, we have a lot of these equations now to determine these coefficients. We can write down what they are. These two are not that difficult to find. I think first what we should do is define some variables. We can define hi equal to xi plus 1 minus xi. And we can define eta I equal to yi plus 1 minus yi. So hi's and eta i's are known because we know these points xi, yi, Okay, so that will simplify our writing. Okay, so how do we determine what these constraints say? So we have gi of xi. That one's easy because xi minus xi is zero. So gi of xi will wipe everything out except di. So that this first constraint here will just determine di. So di equals yi. So that's the first constraint, okay? The second constraint then is gi of xi plus 1 equals yi plus 1. So if we plug in xi plus 1, we'll get ai hi cubed, right, plus bi hi squared plus ci hi plus di, which is yi, equals yi plus 1. So we throw the di on the right of the equation, and here we will simply have an eta I, yi plus 1 minus yi. Okay? So these first two constraints, two n constraints, leads to these equations for the a, b, c, and d coefficients. Okay? The third one then will be that the continuity of the first derivative. So what we will need to do then is to take the derivative of this function, plug in xi plus 1. That will give us the derivative of x minus xi cubed is 3 times x minus xi squared. We plug in xi plus 1 will give us an hi squared, and so on. And that's equal to the derivative of g of I plus 1 at xi plus 1. So then a lot of these terms will be 0. Okay? So I talk about this algebra in the PDF file. I think here on the light board, the easiest thing for me to do then is to write down what the equations are. This one, this continuity of the first derivative then gives us the constraint 3 times ai hi squared plus 2 times bi hi plus ci equals ci plus 1. And then the fourth constraint, that the second derivative is continuous, you do the same process again, and that will give us 6 times ai hi plus 2 times bi equals 2 times bi plus 1. Okay? It's messy, but you can do it. The software, of course, doesn't require you to do any algebra. So when you practically use cubic splines, you just use the functions that MATLAB provides. I just want to show you that it's possible to figure out the algebra. So we have these 4n unknown coefficients. What we're trying to do then is to write equations for these coefficients. We write equations for those coefficients by requiring some constraint on these piecewise cubic polynomials. Two of the constraints is that they have to go through the points. That works to 2n total constraints. And then we're going to make this interpolating polynomial, piecewise polynomial interpolant, as smooth as possible. So we require that the first derivative is continuous, so we don't have these line segments with discontinuous first derivatives. And then that gives us n minus 1 constraints. We also require the second derivative is continuous. That also gives us n minus 1 constraints. So with the 4n unknowns, we have 4n minus 2 constraints. We'll need to come up with two additional constraints to completely solve for the a, b, c, and d coefficients. And we'll do that in the next video. So here I show you what are the equations that we get by applying our constraints. These are the equations for the A, B, C, and D coefficients. In the next video then, in part B, I will put this all together and show you that the end result is actually a matrix equation, which is very nice. So we can use matrix algebra then in MATLAB to solve the resulting matrix equation. I'm Jeff Chasnov. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.